Hi guys, welcome back to GKCodelabs. This is the next video in Apache Spark series. In this session, we will be starting with Spark-SQL, that is another module of Spark that is basically used for structured data processing. As we are following the official documentation of Spark, if you want to access the Spark-SQL page, you can go to Programming Guides, and the third option is SQL Dataframes and Datasets. So this is what we are going to start today. So let us talk about this first. As we know, till now we have worked with RDDs. That is basically, it follows all the Spark concepts, but it is not much interactive. Moreover, in case of structured data, where we have a data set, that can be easily formed into rows and columns, just like a relational database, or on a very small scale that you can say that my data can be easily, few records of that can be easily represented in an Excel that has rows and columns. So if you have such kind of data, such huge kind of data, in that case, using Spark-SQL helps in basically two ways. First is, you can handle this data in Spark. As you know, it is a distributed computing framework. And if somehow you get a feature to process that data in more understandable way, in rows and columns, as your data is meant to be, that will be well and good. So considering that particular use case, which is most common in most of the data processing, Spark has built a Spark-SQL module that handles with such kind of scenarios. So this was the first benefit that we can have. I mean, we can process the data in more understandable way. And on the other hand, the Spark leverages these same features, that the data has a schema. It knows that which column is an integer, which column is a string, which column is meant to be a double, because this data is structured. So it is very easy for Spark to understand that what column has which kind of values, and it leverages the same characteristics of this structured data to optimize the queries. You know, it optimizes your queries or the Spark workload by implementing different optimization techniques, because now it has more information about the data. So Spark engine internally optimizes if you are using data frames or data sets. We'll come to that, what is data frames and data sets, but you can understand, like, in case we are using RDDs, it will be less optimal, less understandable, obviously, as we told. But onto that, the Spark optimizer will handle this data more efficiently as compared to RDDs. So this was basically why the Spark-SQL was introduced into Spark. Also, not only this, the Spark-SQL provides you facilities like you can read the data directly from the files or from the Hive tables and from similar other variety of data sources. So while we'll go through this Spark-SQL, we'll not actually very readily come to this difference between data frames and data sets. I'll discuss it. I'll tell you the basic differences and why you should not get confused between them. But while going through this Spark-SQL, we'll come through this two words, data sets and data frames. So let us discuss what are they, and then we'll move further. So what is a data set now? Many of you have, this is a very common topic in Spark. What is data set, data frame? What are the difference between them? But many of you have got this cleared. Many of you have still some confusion. According to me, in my words, I would say that you should not really get confused into this, because the difference between them is not much to be worried about. Also, after Spark 2.0, it's literally, if you can understand just a small thing, then you won't be confused in this. So what is a data set? I'll tell you. Let me open an Excel. Just simple, you can say that I have three friends. Let me include myself into this. And three friends, just say anyone, John, Justin, anyone, and Sameer, and any. These are, we four are friends. I just wrote down their names. Now I can say that I have a set of names, obviously string type. I have set of names. If you consider it as a data, this data is of string type. So very simply, just clear your concept. You can take this as a data set. This is a data set. That's it. Nothing else. Don't get confused. Now let's see what you have heard earlier, or you have read some blogs. It might sound to you that this is not that simple. How can you say just this is a data set? Yes, this is a data set. Data set is nothing but a collection of data of some specific type. Now, keep this aside for a time being. Let's discuss what is data frame. Let me copy this. Suppose same, I have these four friends, and Arpit's age is 29, his John's age is 30, 35, 40, anything, okay? And let's say their city, Arpit lives in Bangalore, John lives in Chennai, Justin lives in Rajasthan, and Sameer lives in Hyderabad. That's it. Okay. What are these? These are names. These are age. These are city. Okay. Now, what is this? This is a data. Data means a data of people, their ages, and the city they live in, and with the column names, and distributed similarly, just like an Excel sheet data or relational database data. So this is a data frame. I'll come to the technicalities behind this, but this is a data frame. Now, coming to the interesting topic, what is the difference between data set and data frame? The data set is typed. One more thing, very important, listen this carefully. In many places you might see Dataset API supports typed and untyped objects. But what I'm saying, this is typed. I'm calling it a data set, and I'm saying this is a any particular type. Now you have to understand typed and untyped. This is a data set of type string, because the data here, each data is a string. What if I tell you the data frame, that I am calling this a data frame, this is also a data set. This one column you are considering as a data set. Now try to consider and make a same picture of this selection, area of selection, with, compare this with this area of selection. Okay. Similarly, this is also a data set. But in this case, this data set is not of any particular type. This has string, this has some integer or anything it could be, and this is a character or a string. So this, while defining a data frame in Spark, this was a data frame that we were discussing. While defining a data frame, this complete thing is considered as data set of type row. That's it. This is also a data set. This is also a data set. Data frame is also a data set of type row. That is what Spark considers it when we define a data frame. So don't get confused. Let me add one more point. After Spark 2.0, I don't know, I have mentioned it earlier. But after Spark 2.0, these two different APIs or abstractions, data frames and data sets, are unified. They are the same. And now when you see this, Spark data set supports untyped and typed objects. So yes, obviously dataset supports both, but the dataset feature that supports strongly typed or typed objects, that is actually what people refer as a dataset. But the dataset, the different API that we are considering, is nothing but a different feature, that is the strongly typed feature that supports a strongly typed objects, that feature of a dataset. And the data frame, it's nothing but it is a dataset, but it is untyped, because this is a row. Obviously this is a JVM object row, but there is no single type of this. Yes, you can superimpose a type with the use of case classes. I'll come to this once we go through Spark SQL. How do we create a data set, how do we create a data frame? But this is a row type data set, okay? And this complete data set row is untyped. So I hope you got the difference between data frame and data set. And most of the places, I'll tell you that in the interview questions also, hardly I think anyone will ask they might ask the difference between data frame and data set, but that question won't be much deep. The conceptually, they want to assess your knowledge, that are you aware of these things, but there won't be any deep coding or used case based question. Slight optimizations are different, but there won't be much variety of questions in data frame versus data sets, because they also understand, if you understand it conceptually, there is not much difference. Things are same, just they are handling different types. Okay, So this was the difference between data set and data frames. A small benefit I can tell that why do you use data frame, data sets? I don't think it's relevant if you are not much into Spark coding. We will, while our coding examples, we'll take one or two examples in data sets also. But whatever circus I told you here, that this is a specific type, this is a row type, not a specific Java object. What is the need of this? This you can understand like when you create a data set, this is typed, and this is not just typed in a sense. Typed actually means this is that type of JVM object. If there is a typed JVM object, in that case, suppose you have a data set. Data set can also be in rows and columns. Just for the time being, consider this as a data set, not a data frame. Okay. These are the column names, but it still doesn't have the type, but you can impose it using the case classes and map it to the same data using the as keyword. In that case, considering one record, this will be a string Java object, JVM object. This will be a string JVM object. This will be a int JVM object. This will be whatever the data is there. And this will be handled like representation of this JVM objects in a tabular format like this. This is handled by encoders. So there is a concept of Spark encoders in data sets that will handle this converting this JVM object into tabular format and handling the data in that tabular format. And once all the records in this data are JVM objects, in that case, we get one more benefit that these are JVM objects. In this case, suppose we are firing any filter or simple select query on this data, and suppose by mistake or we are suppose there are thousands of columns, and we fired a query in some of the column that doesn't even exist. In that case, the error that we'll get will be at compile time, because these are JVM objects that will be caught up at the compile time itself. The error in the statements using them will be caught up at the compile time itself. It won't go till runtime. On the other side, if it were a data frame, we would surely get the error because the column does not exist, but that will be received at a runtime. So this is also a small benefit that we get if you are using data set. So all in all, this was the main difference. Just understand this concept. If you have missed something, please watch this video again. And theoretically, just make sure of two points, that how is it different on the typed and untyped data. Once again, the untyped data set is a data frame, that is data set of row type. And the second theoretical important point that you can make a note of is the runtime and compile time, what I just told. And apart from this, if you have it in some use case and you face some issues, please let me know in the comment section. And I would suggest don't bother much on the differences between a data frame and data set. Rather than practice more on the operations that you can do with the help of data frames or data sets, like handling the data, grouping, aggregating, all that practice is more important than these theoretical differences, which are very small. So from next session, we are going to continue with all the coding and hands-on, that is Spark session, creating data frames, data set. You can see in the documentation also, they have mentioned untyped data set operations, also known as data frame operation. Untyped data sets, as I just told, is a data frame. Fine. So in the next session, we'll continue with this coding and hands-on. So if you liked the video and now the difference between data set and data frame is clear to you, please hit that like button and please subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. Thank you guys. See you later.